For the bone sample preparation, we will first dissect a rat to extract the femur. We will need a cutting board, a rat, tweezers, large scissors to cut through the bone, fine scissors to cut through tissues and muscle, a scalpel, and a squirt bottle with alcohol. If the rat is frozen, partially defrost for 2 hours in the refrigerator to facilitate manipulations. Lay the rat on its back and clean the skin of the lower part of the abdomen by saturating it with alcohol. This will also help to prevent cut hair from spreading. Retract a leg away from the body and with scissors, cut the skin and muscle from the groin up to the hip from both the posterior and anterior parts of the leg. And cut through the ilium bone to free the leg from the body. And ensure not to damage the femur or the femoral head. Then remove the skin from the leg by lifting the skin at the base of the leg with tweezers and cutting away the skin across the thigh and down to the ankle. Note that after this step, the specimen can be frozen for prolonged conservation. If the leg is frozen, let it thaw at 4 degrees for at least 45 minutes beforehand, then place the leg on the cutting board. Remove the tissue around the hip joint and cut any ligament or tendons so that the hip bone can be removed from the femoral head. This can be done using either a scalpel or fine scissors. Then remove muscle from the entire femur so that the bone is completely exposed. Be very careful not to cut the femur as it will compromise the test sample. Then separate the femur from the tibia by removing excess tissue from around the knee joint so that the lateral ligaments can be cut with a scalpel. Then bend the knee joint to expose the interior cruciate ligament and cut it using either scissors or a scalpel. The femur and tibia should now separate easily. Note to never pull the tibia from the femur while the ligaments are still attached to these two bones, as this can break the femoral condyles of the femur. Rub the femur with a dry handpaper or dust-free wipe to remove any remaining soft tissues. Make sure that both extremities of the femurs are free from chunks of soft tissues. Dry the femur by leaving it on the bench for 2 hours. Then the dry bone can either be stored frozen for a prolonged period of time or processed for mechanical testing.